Praise the Lord. This is the day the Lord has made. We'll rejoice and be glad in it. Welcome to another day. Welcome to Morning Glow. Welcome to a brand new day in the presence of the Lord. Trust in the Lord that today will be a day of greatness, a day of power, a day of the manifestation of the blessing and the favor of God on your life. It will be a day when God pours mercy beyond measure on your life. A day when you enjoyed His hand of mercy on your life. Remember, we've been sharing on mercy, and I'm trusting the Lord that you will truly walk in the mercy and grace of the Lord. Heavenly Father, the great Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we awesomely magnify your name, the God of mercy. We serve a God of mercy. There is no God like you who shows mercy to his people. Your mercy wakes us up. Your mercy sends us to bed. In your mercy, you forgive our sin. You cleanse us from unrighteousness. In your mercy, you surround us with love unspeakable and full of glory. Today, we glorify you because of that mercy. Bless us, bless us, bless us, bless us, bless us, bless us. Beyond imagination, let the heavens open up on your people. Let the testimony of Jesus be awesome in their lives. Let your name be glorified. In Jesus' name. Amen, 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 amen. Praise the Lord. Wherever you are this morning and you are joining us, we trust the Lord that you will be blessed beyond imagination. The hand of the Lord will touch you and God will fill your mouth with testimony. The word mercy, which is in several ways they are shown in the scripture, is the heart of God. The God who so desires to show us mercy, he made a seat of mercy. So when we come to him in judgment, his judgment to us is in mercy. Glory to God. In Psalm 103 verse 8, it says, the Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger, and abounding in mercy. Abounding in mercy. The nature of God's mercy is shown in the fact that God is compassionate in his treatment of those who are in distress. That is the kind of compassion he has. The nature of God's mercy is that he is the one who is gracious. He is slow to anger. That's exactly what our passage says this morning. The nature of the mercy of God is also shown to us in Jeremiah chapter 3 verse 12, where God himself said, I am merciful. I will not retain or remain angry forever. That's the kind of God we serve. And so today you are going into the day with this mercy of God wrapping around you. In Joel chapter 2, verse 13, it says, the Lord your God, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger. Gracious, merciful, slow to anger. Let me quickly give you a beautiful caveat here. We separate these words, but in the operations of God, sometimes mercy will flow, favor will enter, grace will enter. Sometimes you can't quite say which one is in operation. They are each distinct, but they are like the cooking of a beautiful gravy or stew. Mercy, grace, favor make up this wonderful stew of God that comes into your life to make your life beautiful and awesome and to make your life a testimony. The nature of the mercy of God is that he is merciful even when we have been unrighteous and when we have not done the right thing. Hebrews chapter 8 verse 12, it says, I will be merciful to their unrighteousness and their sins and their lawless deeds. I will remember no more. Glory to God. Glory to God. So he is a God who has mercy. Part of his mercy also, the nature of his mercy also is that he shows it to those whom some of us will have marked down and say, you don't deserve mercy. But in Romans chapter 9, from verse 15 down to 18, he said, I will have mercy on whom I will have mercy, and compassion on whom I will have compassion. And when God says he will show a person mercy and compassion, who are you to question? Glory to God. And you can't stop him from showing them mercy. That is the nature of the mercy of God. Some people will look at them, will say they don't deserve the clemency, the love, the compassion of God. Yet he shows them. In Exodus 33, he said, I will have compassion on whom I will have compassion. So God distributes his mercy at will. And you know, the nature of his compassion or mercy is such that the time he shows it is at the time of our weakest, when we are at the weakest. Romans 5, from verse 2 to verse 6, says, when we were sinners, when we were weak, and when we were without strength, when we were ungodly, that was when he showed his mercy. Oh, glory. And I believe that this morning, wherever you are, this mercy will be shown to you in a powerful way. And the nature of this mercy of God will work in your life. Psalm 103 verse 17 goes further to describe the nature of the mercy of God. Psalm 103 verse 17 says, the mercy of the Lord is from everlasting, kaliberosia, to everlasting, to those who fear him. We would think that it ended at salvation, but it is from everlasting to everlasting. God's mercy is not only wide, it is deep. It's not only deep, it is high. So wide we can't get around it, so deep we can't get under it, and so high we can't get over it. What a marvelous blessing indeed. God be praised for his great mercy. Great mercy. Human beings, when they have powers to show clemency, don't. Do you know that most prime ministers, presidents, governors, part of the powers they have is to go to the prisons at different times and just show clemency, either to people whose cases are not as hard as staying in prison, or some people who they've paid their dues. Some will just not do anything. They don't care. But this our God, he would remember a person to show them mercy. This season, God will remember you to show you mercy, to bless your life, to bring you healing. And in his mercy, the things you were told will never come to pass will become the reality of your life. What is the manifestation of the mercy of God? What is the manifestation of the mercy of God? The best way to understand this is to realize that it manifests when it looks like you should be damned, you should be destroyed. Lot, because of covetousness, went to live in Sodom, but in the mercy of God, God went to deliver him out of a city of destruction. And guess what? Even when the angel of the Lord came, I mean, God sent angels to go and deliver him on account of Abraham, his uncle. The angels got there. Genesis 19:16 is an interesting one. It says, while he lingered, the men took hold of his hand and his wife's hand and the hands of his two daughters, and the Lord being merciful to him, and they brought him out and set him outside the city. Lot lingered. Lot lingered. Many lingering Lots fill up our churches today. Lot lingered, but the Lord showed him compassion. Lot lingered. The Lord showed him mercy. In mercy, God sent messengers to rescue him. God had compassion on them, rescued his whole family. Happily, his wife lagged behind, kept looking back. Her eyes were on the high society behind. Mrs. Lot never made it out. Mercy was available to her, but she took the mercy of God for granted. She became a mound of salt. Even her husband lingered. So we need to realize that mercy wants to manifest for us. And I pray for you today in a such a powerful, 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 powerful way. Mercy will be shown to you in a way that will be beyond your own imagination in the name of Jesus. In Psalm 136, David sang of the mercy of God and referred repeatedly to the demonstration of this mercy. You say, who did this and this and this? For his mercy endures forever. Who did that to the children of Israel? For his mercy endures forever. To him who struck Egypt in their firstborn, for his mercy endures forever. To him who brought out Israel from among them, for his mercy. Psalm 136 is a lovely, powerful testimony of the manifestation of the mercy of God. The one who with a strong hand and an outstretched hand brought out Israel, for his mercy endures forever. The one who divided the Red Sea into two, for his mercy endures forever. The one who made Israel pass through the midst of it, for his mercy endures forever. The one who overthrew Pharaoh and his army in the Red Sea, for his mercy endures forever. To him who led his people through the wilderness, for his mercy endures forever. To him who struck down great kings, for his mercy endures forever. The one who gave their land as a heritage, for his mercy endures forever. Glory to God. Glory to God. And I pray that your testimony will be written like that. For his mercy endures forever. For his mercy endures forever. For his mercy endures forever. Despite your mistakes and sin and unrighteousness, may his mercy endure forever to you. Nehemiah in chapter 9 was talking about how, you know, he was in slavery. Nehemiah was a man who came back from Babylon, released by the king of Babylon to go and rebuild Jerusalem. Why did they end up in slavery? In Nehemiah 9, verse 16 and 17, Nehemiah shows us why they went to slavery, but God still showed mercy. He said, our fathers acted proudly, hardened their necks, and did not heed your commandment. They refused to obey, and they were not mindful of your wonders that you did among them. But they hardened their necks, and in their rebellion, they appointed a leader to return to their bondage. But you are God, ready to pardon, gracious and merciful, slow to anger, abundant in kindness, and you did not forsake them. Father, we bless you because of your kind of mercy. You did not forsake them. You did not wipe them out of this earth. When worms, ordinary human beings, think they are big deal compared to you, the God who spoke the universe into existence, we magnify you for your mercy. Mercy. Mercy, Lord. Mercy. Mercy, Father. Mercy. Mercy, Lord. Mercy. Mercy. David, king of Israel, also sang one time. He said, for his mercy endures forever. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. This morning, you are walking practically into the mercy of God. You are walking practically into the grace of God. You are walking practically into the testimony of Jesus Christ. Mercy will increase for you. Mercy will abound unto you. Mercy will be manifest in your life, and you will have an uncommon testimony. Barodozi Balema Tonahitia Herabo Kerababosha Liba Ambosoya Edibarosha Eparobo Shikaedesa. In Jesus' name. Mercy, 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 mercy. Let's see how it reflects in our life today. Let me see with you how God's mercy reflects for us. Praise the Lord. In Luke chapter 6 verse 36, Jesus said, "Be merciful, just as your Father also is merciful." That makes very clear that we also need to show mercy. You know, we love to receive mercy from God, but we need to know how to show mercy to other people. In Proverbs 3:3, it says, "Let not mercy and truth forsake you. Bind them upon your neck. Write them on the tablet of your heart." In other words, we need to wake some mornings and say, "Who can I show mercy? What can I do to reflect the mercy of God to the needy, to the broke, to the poor, to the widow, to the fatherless?" And not just once in a blue moon. Some people, they say, "It's going to be my 40th birthday. I'm going to spend the day with orphans." Then they'll buy some lousy bread and rice and chicken and spend the day with orphans. One day in 40 years, and that's all you can give? No. God wants you to be able to see mercy as a massive thing you give. Major thing you do. Glory to God Almighty. Micah chapter 6 verse 8. In Micah chapter 6 verse 8, it says, "What does the Lord require of you but to do justly, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with your God?" Ekaba lekotoraba. The good Samaritan, a priest went by, did not help that man. Not only did he not help, a Levite went by, did not help the man. But the person they were avoiding, the Samaritan, was the one who showed him mercy. And Jesus said, that is his neighbor. And then he said, "Go and do likewise." Irabakaya, ikalebo sokaya, ikarababo shekaya ba, ikaye no soka barata le karaba roske de barasha, ikaya ba ba ba, rokaya ba sebari. I pray today that somebody at this altar will walk in the dimension of mercy and compassion of God, that God will make us experience His mercy, but that we also will show compassion and mercy to people who are in distress, that we will look out for them, not during our 40th, 50th, 60th birthday, but to make it a constant virtue that flows from us to other people. So just as God shows mercy, He wants us to learn to call upon Him and for us to also allow us to be the channel through which He shows mercy to people who are distressed, people who are in need, people who are broken, people who are troubled, people who are challenged, people who are battles of life. Titaraba akosa. Reka pekoshataya bale shikaba rotoniske yaba. That you truly will be the one who shows mercy. You know, Jesus asked that lawyer after he told the story of the Samaritan. He said, "So, who among these three is the neighbor of the thief?" The lawyer answered, "He who showed mercy on him." He who showed mercy on the thief. He who showed mercy on him is the one who is his neighbor. This morning we pray that as we are about to call for the mercy of the Lord to come on our lives, that we ourselves will be people who manifest that mercy of God on a large scale, that will manifest it among our neighbors, manifest it among those who qualify, manifest it to those who do not qualify, that from our life there will be an outflow of the mercy of God. Wherever you have joined from this morning, the east of the world, the north of the world, the west of the world, the south of the world, get ready to be touched by God. Get ready for the heavens to open upon you and for God to show you mercy beyond measure in the name of Jesus. In a world of constant breakdown, famine, recession, death, the things ravaging nations, this morning as a servant of Jesus Christ, I prophesy on your life. Letika parodosia, ma alishka parodosa, that you will walk in uncommon favor, uncommon mercy. Uncommon favor, uncommon mercy. There is a mercy of God that breaks the power of sweat and struggles. When God shows you this kind of mercy, it is not on account of your ability that you prosper. It is on account of His ability. May you know this level of mercy. May you experience this level of mercy. There is a mercy that causes God to rise in battle for you, to take on your fight, to fight those who fight you, to battle with those who battle with you. Receive such mercy in the name of Jesus. Listen, we're going to go through scriptures. I'm going to speak the scriptures on your life. And you're going to see the mercy of God in this season. Mercy at home, mercy at work. Mercy on the things you lay your hands on. Mercy in the places you turn to in the name of Jesus. Psalm 33 verses 16 to 22. No king is saved by the multitude of an army. A mighty man is not delivered by great strength. A horse is a vain hope for safety. Neither shall it deliver any by its great strength. Behold, the eye of the Lord is on those who fear Him, on those who hope in His mercy, to deliver their soul from death, keep them alive in famine. Our soul waits on the Lord. He is our help and our shield. Our heart shall rejoice in Him because we have trusted in His holy name. Let your mercy, O Lord, be upon us, just as we hope in you. Today I declare into your life this early morning, I speak into your life today that as your eyes are on the Lord, may His mercy be your hope. May His mercy be your strength. May His mercy be your hope. May His mercy be your strength. May His mercy be your hope. May the mercy of the Lord surround you, garrison your life. Pali kapito pinatini kapreto noskayere diska paretale raba. Rika palosia amprotolishka dabari didas. That the Lord by His mercy will walk mightily in your life in the name of Jesus. He said, for our heart shall rejoice in Him because we have trusted in His holy name. Let your mercy, O Lord, be upon us. Lord, I pray upon your people today as they go to work, as they go to various places, that your mercy will surround them, your mercy will garrison them, your mercy will protect their mind in Jesus' name. Isaiah 30, verses 18 to 21. Isaiah 30, verses 18 to 21. Therefore, the Lord will wait, that He may be gracious to you, and therefore He will be exalted, that He may have mercy on you. For the Lord is a God of justice. Blessed are all those who wait for Him. For the people shall dwell in Zion, at Jerusalem you shall weep no more. He will be very gracious to you at the sound of your cry. When He hears it, He will answer. I love this last verse. For the people shall dwell in Zion at Jerusalem. You shall weep no more. God will be gracious to you at the sound of your cry. To be gracious is also to be merciful. I speak into your life today in this season of your life that God will show you mercy as you have cried to Him on major and minor matters. Neta akapa kupari neshkadi dosatia. That the Lord Himself will make your matter, your case, your challenge, your battle is battle. And he will listen to your cry. The Bible says when he hears it, he will answer you. The Lord will answer you. In this season of your life, the Lord will answer you. At this time in your journey, God will answer you. God will answer you. I decree, God will answer you. We didn't read verse 20, 21. And though the Lord gives you the bread of adversity and the water of affliction, yet your teachers will not be moved into a corner anymore, but your eyes shall see your teachers. Your ears shall hear a word behind you saying, this is the way, walk in it. Whenever you turn to the right hand and whenever you turn to the left, by the mercy of God, divine direction. In this month of July, by the mercy of God, clarity of direction, where you should not go, where you will be hurt, God will preclude you from there. No accident, no danger, no battle in your way. Arrows of darkness failing for your sake. Testimony following, glory following you in the name of Jesus. Isaiah 60, verses 10 to 13. The sons of foreigners shall build your walls, Arabosha. Your kings, their kings shall minister to you. For in my wrath I struck you, but in my mercy and favor, in my favor I have had compassion, I have had mercy on you. Glory. Therefore your gates shall be open continually. It shall not be shut anymore. Men will bring to you the wealth of Gentiles, and their kings will come in procession. For nations and kingdoms which will not serve you shall perish, and those nations shall be utterly ruined. The glory of Lebanon shall come to you. The cypress, the pine, the box tree, to beautify the place of my sanctuary, and I'll make the place of my feet glorious. Oh, this is powerful. Foreigners will build your house. People who you don't know will serve you. In mercy, their kings will be your servants. When it says their kings shall minister to you, the word minister there is what happens when you go to a restaurant and the waiter comes with a towel on his arm waiting on you. Their kings will wait on you because of mercy. He said, because in my wrath I struck you, but in my favor I will show you mercy. God will show you mercy that opens gates. Mercy that brings you into a position of elevation. Mercy that brings you to the place of blessing. Mercy that lifts you to the place of total victory. Mercy that will change your story, silence the enemy, shut the mouth of devil, give you victory in the name of Jesus. There will be a dimension of mercy like you have never known in the mighty name of Jesus. Nations. Will rise to help you, rise to bless you, rise to serve you in the name of Jesus. Psalm 25 verse 10, all the paths of the Lord are mercy and truth to such as keep his covenant and his testimonies. So the ways of the Lord, the paths of the Lord are full of mercy and truth. This day I declare to your life, as you walk in the path of righteousness for his name's sake, may you enjoy the mercy of God. The mercy that protects. Some of you are traveling and this is mercy. In the name of Jesus, mercy. In the mighty name of Jesus, mercy. In the holy name of Jesus, mercy. Psalm 33, verse 22, let your mercy, O Lord, be upon us, just as we hope on you. May the mercy of God be upon you as you travel. Mercy, 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 mercy. Jehovah reigns. His mercy reigns. Jehovah reigns. His mercy reigns. In your journey, mercy. In your going out, mercy. In your coming in, mercy. In the things you lay your hands to do, mercy. In Jesus' name. Isaiah 14, verse 1 and 2. Isaiah 14, verse 1 and 2. For the Lord will have mercy on Jacob. I love this. And will still choose Israel and settle them in their own land. Strangers will join with them. They will cling to the house of Jacob. This is when mercy manifests in your life powerfully. People will be clinging to you because they can see the hand of the Lord in your life. Then people will take them and bring them to their place, and the house of Israel will possess them for servants and maids in the land of the Lord. They will take them captive, whose captives they were, and rule over their oppressors. Mercy will turn the table round for you. 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 Kakabalishke toromale kabarona binota barinta baralosa. Mercy, mercy, mercy will turn the table round for you. Mercy will change the story, will bring you to the place where you are the head and not the tail, above, never under. Glory will be upon you in the name of Jesus. Ikapaloja. Itarabaoshikaya, Zile Rebaboshika, Zamwa Koteyabara, Reba Kotole Barabosha, Ikarabababo, Irabosa, in Jesus' name. Psalm 27, verse 7. Psalm 27, verse 7. Hear, O Lord, when I cry with my voice. Have mercy upon me and answer me. Remember in verse 1, same Psalm 27, he said, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the enemy came to eat my flesh, you, the Lord, break their mouth, break their teeth. But then in verse 7, he said, hear, O Lord, when I cry with my voice. Have mercy upon me and answer me. The Lord who is your light will hear your cry. You will not cry in vain. You will not wait in vain. You will not make the declaration in vain. You will not speak the word in vain. You will not declare the decree in vain. Your eyes will see the testimony. Your eyes will see the testimony. Your eyes will testify. Your eyes will testify. Your ears will testify. Your mouth will testify. Your eye will see it and testify. Your mouth will hear, will speak it and testify of what the Lord has done for you in the name of Jesus. Balosha kabarada rosha rika maliza no parentelish kayeda basi telerama telerebarosa. In Jesus' name, in the name of Jesus, glory to God. Psalm 123, verse 2 to 4. Psalm 123, verse 2 to 4. Behold, as the eye of the servant looks to the hand of the masters, as the eyes of a maid to the hand of her mistress, so our eyes look to the Lord our God until he has mercy on us. Have mercy on us, O Lord. Have mercy on us. For we are exceedingly filled with contempt. Dikabaros, Maretalosha, Rikali Yeshereba. Our soul is exceedingly filled with scorn of those who are at ease with the contempt of the proud. Just as the eye of a servant looks to the master, the eye of a maid looks to her mistress. We look to the Lord today. Everything you have come to the altar with this morning, this beautiful July morning, I declare and decree it is becoming your testimony. The hand of the Lord is making it a possibility. The hand of the Lord is making it a possibility. The hand of the Lord is making it a possibility. The hand of the Lord is making it a possibility. Mercy is pity. May God have his pity on you. Mercy is compassion. May the Lord show you his greatest compassion. Mercy is a forgiving attitude towards somebody that you have power to harm or punish. Psalm 103 verse 8 to 11. May the God who have such power show it in compassion towards you by going ahead of you, opening the doors, bringing healing for you, bringing testimony to your life, bringing glory to your life in the name of Jesus. In mercy, God says, I won't give you what you deserve because of my love. I will give you something better. Mercy makes God not to give you what you deserve. He gives you something better. Kapa kusa tita libra. Every desire of your heart in recent time, every prayer, every cry, every desire of your heart in recent time, every prayer, every cry, every prayer, every cry becomes a testimony in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Mercy is God's love, his loyal love and benevolence towards us, by which he stops disasters, calamities, accidents. Today, I lay hands of faith on everyone on this altar. This benevolent love shown in mercy shall garrison your life. No disaster, no loss of life, no disaster, no loss of life, no disaster, no loss of life, no disaster, no loss of life. In the name of Jesus, no disaster, no loss of life. Mercy is the action of the strong as they help the weak. Mercy, the action of the strong to help the weak. Psalm 6, verse 2. Have mercy on me, O Lord, for I am weak. O Lord, heal me, for my bones are troubled. It is the sovereign God's decision to help people. So this morning, I speak into your life that this sovereign God will rise to help you. It is his mercy that he wants to show you. You are weak, he is strong. You are weak, he is strong. You are weak, he is strong. I pray for you today that this mercy will take over the place of your weakness and prove the presence of God might in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Mercy is divine involvement in the affairs of man to terminate struggles. Kayaya protakaba. The involvement of Jehovah in your matter to bring an end to struggle. I will have compassion on whom I will have compassion. Romans 9, 15 and 16. And I will have mercy on whom I will have mercy. So that it is not of him who wills, nor of him who runs, but of God who shows mercy. God will show you 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 mercy. 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 In the name of Jesus. Mercy is a gift from God, not based on your ability. It's a gift, not based on your ability. Exodus 34, verse 6 and 7. And the Lord passed before him and proclaimed, the Lord God, merciful and gracious, long-suffering, abounding in goodness and truth, keeping mercy for thousands, forgiving iniquity and transgression and sin, by no means clearing the guilty, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children and the children's children to the third and fourth generation. Mercy is a gift from God, not based on your ability. Credo Shiaba, Ika Pararosa. He should have visited our iniquity. He should have visited the iniquity of our fathers, but instead he showed us mercy. Today I declare that this year, this is the second half of the year, you will experience an uncommon mercy of God by way of provision, by way of protection, by way of providing, by way of protection, in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. God is a God of mercy, but he still brings judgment against evil wickedness. I speak against every satanic action that is against you. The hand of the Lord is against them. In his mercy, he will cover you. In his mercy, he will fight your enemy. Psalm 9 verse 17, the wicked shall be turned into hell. And all the nations that forget God, mercy is what makes God grant us forgiveness and eternal life. This day, God will grant you mercy. He will show you eternal life. He will show you favor. He will show you testimony. He will show you grace. He will show you blessing in the name of Jesus. Mercy is a disposition to pardon the guilty. Lord, we come today, we bring everything that will stop our blessing. We bring it under the blood. We plead 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 the blood in the name of Jesus. Mercy comes from the spring of divine goodness. It says, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. Psalm 23 verse 6. It comes from the spring of divine goodness. Surely goodness and mercy shall flow to me all the days of my life. I speak into your life today. All the days of your life, mercy. 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 In the name of Jesus. God is rich in mercy. The Bible says so in Ephesians chapter 2 verse 4. Rich in mercy. May he manifest the richness of his mercy in your life in the name of Jesus. God is the Father of all mercies. 2 Corinthians 1:3. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and God of all comfort. Lita Baba, Rubia Rabo, he is the Father of all mercies and is your Father. Mercy, therefore, will surround you. In mercy, you will lay hands on new projects, and mercy of God will make you achieve it. By the mercy of God, you will not fail. By the mercy of God, you will excel. By the mercy of God, angels will be released on your behalf in matters that relate to you. In the name of Jesus. It is the attribute and foundation of our intercession. Without mercy, our prayer is going nowhere. Lord, we come before you today. We cry to you for mercy. As we intercede, as we pray, in your mercy, make it come to pass. In your mercy, make our prayers come to pass. A prayer of protection, provision. A prayer for power. A prayer for peace. Let it come to pass in the name of Jesus. Mercy is a sovereign act of God. You can't force him to show mercy. But in his choice, he sovereignly shows mercy. That's why he messes up some people. When they see whom God showed mercy, they are thinking, God, I know this lady's case. I know this man's issues. And God will say, I have chosen to show him mercy. What's your stress? He's my son and it's a family matter. Psalm 130 verse 7. O Israel, hope in the Lord. For with the Lord there is mercy and with him is abundant redemption. Trakakosia. As you hope in Jehovah, as you put your trust in Jehovah, you will not be put to shame. Mercy will cry out for you. Mercy will speak out for you. In the name of Jesus. The mercy of God never expires. So I declare into your life from this morning to the end of July, beginning of August, to the end of August, beginning of September, to the end of September, from the beginning of October to the end of October, beginning November, so, or November, end of November, September to the end, December to the end. Mercy will not leave your house. Mercy will surround you. Mercy will abound in your life in a powerful, awesome way in the name of Jesus. Problems will expire, but mercy endures forever. Hallelujah. Kabale Shitia. Psalm 100:5. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures to all generations. Problems expire. Issues we face and look like it's going to kill us. They come, they go. His mercy stays. May mercy never leave your house. May mercy make a residence in your house. May mercy make a residence in your house. May the one who made mercy his seat come and sit in your house. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Mercy is a two-edged sword. Like I said, it punishes one person, it delivers another. Psalm 143:12. In your mercy, cut off my enemies and destroy those who afflict my soul, for I am your servant. By the mercy of God, he will be like the, when I was a little boy, a parent or your mother fighting on your behalf will come and back you and put you behind and take on your fight. May the mercy of God come back you, take on your fight, protect you. So mercy is between you and the trouble. Mercy becomes your protection. You are behind. The arrow no longer sees you. When the arrow is shot, it saw the one who showed you mercy. And he can swallow any arrow. I pray for you today that mercy will swallow the arrow shot at you. Then he will rise against the one who have risen against you. Dede Baba Asha. Our God is a God of mercy. In 1 Kings 3:6, he says his mercy is great. May the greatness of his mercy be shown in your life as the Lord lives. May the greatness of his mercy be shown in your life as the Lord lives. In Psalm 136, his mercy endures forever. Can stand. Tina Yabako, Male Kobaresha, Rekoba. May the mercy of the Lord endure any battle, endure any challenge, endure any situation, endure any arrow thrown, endure any lie spoken, endure any fight they bring against you. Nika Deborosa. Nepali kasha diababosha, nikapo kosoyetare baba. To him who doeth wonders, for his mercy endureth forever. May the wonders of God never cease in your life. To him who by wisdom made the heavens, for his mercy endures forever. May the heavens open unto you in the name of Jesus. To him who stretched out the earth above the waters, for his mercy endures forever. May the one who stretched out the earth above the waters make provisions. Every place the sole of your feet shall tread upon, Joshua 1:3, shall be yours in the name of Jesus. To him that made great lights, for his mercy endures forever. May light shine in your journey because of him. You will not walk in darkness. You will not operate in darkness. You will not live in darkness. To him that smote Egypt in her firstborn, for his mercy endures forever. Every big enemy, small enemy, the ones that thought you are too small for them, that have decided to swallow you up, the Lord will take them on. God will wrestle them and give you victory. To him who brought out Israel from among them, for his mercy endures forever. I declare, decree is bringing you out of every challenge. Somebody's at this altar this morning. You have a case against you, a major case. In fact, there's a whole panel, and there's another one. It is judicial. Takaditu makarete kaba retotepa kabarotosetia aparadosha. They shall justify you. They shall rule in your favor. 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 Everyone that is incensed against you will have no word to speak. God will not allow them to gainsay. Airadesha, Bakadi Kataya, Makaraba. Hey, the case shall blow away. It shall not be like you thought. It shall be like vapor of soap. It shall be like the foam of soap. You want to grab it, but you can't handle it. There's nothing to handle. nadidi, nadidi, radida, barado, kebaro, kebara, shidaya, in Jesus' name. To him who divided the Red Sea for his mercy endures forever, every Red Sea, every challenge that wants to stand between you and your testimony is dividing up. God is making a way where there is no way because of mercy. God is making a way where there is no way because of mercy. God is making a way where there is no way because of mercy. The one who overthrew Pharaoh and his host in the Red Sea for his mercy endures forever. Every Pharaoh that says you will not reach the promised land. Every Pharaoh that threatens your destiny. Pharaoh threatened the firstborn of God after the covenant. Israel is God's firstborn after the covenant. And Pharaoh threatened the firstborn of God after the covenant. And God showed him. Every Pharaoh that have risen against your testimony shall perish in their own Red Sea because of the mercy of the Lord. To him who led his people through the wilderness, for his mercy endures forever. Nakababadi telibara dodoske biyara nosha. The journey ahead of you shall only end in testimony. The journey ahead of you shall only end in glory. The journey ahead of you shall only end in favor. The journey ahead of you shall only end in testimony. In the name of Jesus. To him who smote great kings for his people, for his mercy endures forever. Great battles, great challenges, issues of life that look too big for you, that scare you, shall become your stepping stone. They shall become your stepping stone. You will not run from them. You will use them to rise. The one who slew the famous kings, Sion of the Amorites, Og of the Bashan, for his mercy endures forever. Anything that have exalted itself above the knowledge of Christ. Kings of this earth, demonic kings, powerful continental spirits, principalities and powers that have risen against you, against your calling, against your destiny. God humiliates them and silences them for your sake in the name of Jesus. The one who gave their land for an heritage, for his mercy endures forever. Today I bless your hand. Lands, properties, real estate. Lands, properties, real estate. Lands, properties, real estate. By mercy, the house they thought you don't qualify to get, the property you also know you do not qualify to get, is coming into your hand. The one who remembered them in their low estate, for his mercy endures forever. God will remember you. God will remember you. When men have overlooked you, God will remember you. When men have bypassed you, God will remember you. When men have talked you down, God will remember you. When men have said you are nothing, God will remember you. When men have said you are lesser than them, God will remember you. The one who redeemed us from our enemies, for his mercy endures forever. Everyone who have made himself your enemy have made themselves enemies of God. Everything that is in enmity against your victory, your possessions, your testimony, your progress, God fights them. Jehovah fights them. 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 The one who gives food to all flesh, for his mercy endures forever. Everything you will need, the Bible says, for his mighty hand has given us everything that pertaineth to life and godliness. Who giveth food to all flesh, for his mercy endures forever. This day I declare, decree to your life, the one who gives us everything richly to enjoy shall this day also make your testimony to be known. Baleka baronozo, bayeneka baronosketa, paneta lorabozi. Ayabah, the one who called you to an inheritance incorruptible. 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 4 says, to an inheritance incorruptible, undefiled, that fadeth not away, reserved in heaven. The one who gave them food in the wilderness, and have now called you to an inheritance incorruptible. Go into this week and prosper. Go into today and do well. Go into the coming days and excel, excel, excel. 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 4 is also beautiful. It says he'd been called whereby are given unto us exceeding and precious promises, that by these ye might be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through worldly lusts. So this day, and no, verse 3 is where I really love. According to his divine power, he hath given to us all things that pertaineth to life and godliness through the knowledge of him that hath called us to glory and virtue. You are not called to shame and embarrassment. You were called to glory. You were called to virtue. He has given everything to beautify your life. And in his mercy, they shall manifest. In his mercy, everything God earmarked, lands, possessions, peace, joy, healing, spiritual progress, material progress, physical progress, that he had marked and put your name on, shall begin to show up in your life, shall begin to manifest in your life, shall begin to show up in your life. In the kaparunotiski itali pronotali introdos malerika kakosia irodashiti yabambrorosa. God will cause you to have an uncommon testimony. This season of your life will be the best season you've ever known. Best favor, best testimony, best breakthrough, best favor, best testimony, best breakthrough, best season, best favor, best testimony, best breakthrough, best favor, best testimony. In the name of Jesus, you will go out with joy. You'll be led forth with peace. The mountains and the hills will break forth with singing before you. This is your day of mercy. Mercy will never cease in your house. There is a general mercy of God that he places on all men who cry to him. Psalm 145, verse 19, it shall be in your house. There is a special mercy by which he takes care of his own children, irrespective of what they may have done. Matthew 5:45, that you may be sons of your Father in heaven, for he makes his son rise on the evil and on the good, and sends rain on the just and on the unjust. But you are his child. Mercy will surround you. Mercy will make your life beautiful. Mercy will silence the voice of darkness. There is a sovereign mercy reserved for those who are the heirs of salvation. I close with this verse, the most popular verse in the New Testament of mercy. I close with it. Hebrews 4:16, let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help us in the time of need. Upon this throne of grace, God has enthroned mercy. Oh, wow. Upon the throne of grace, God has made mercy to sit there. Mercy waits for you in Zion. Mercy will meet you. Mercy will heal you. Mercy will silence your enemy. Mercy will shut the mouth of devils. Mercy will make the provisions. I just saw that. I release the angel of mercy, the angel of mercy, the angel of mercy, the angel of mercy, the angel of mercy to surround you right now, right now, right now. The thing should have destroyed you, but it will not be able to destroy you. That accident should have taken you, but it will not be able to touch you. The angel of mercy everywhere you are for the rest of this year. The angel of mercy to surround you, surround you, surround you, surround you, to surround you, to surround you. Thank you, Lord. We declare these things to be. We declare these things to be. We declare these things to be. Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy. This day I declare you will obtain mercy. Go into today, go into the rest of this month, and walk in the mercy of God. In Jesus' name. Amen, 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 amen. I'm sure you were blessed this morning. Remember the 60-day challenge. Let us continue to enjoy our time in the Word of God. Look at how we sought mercy in the whole of Scriptures. It comes alive when you also know those passages personally. Continue to flow in there. Remember the International Gathering of Champions. We're looking forward to a great conference. Souls will be saved. People will be delivered. The hand of the Lord will be stretched. It's a conference of His extraordinary works. That's our theme. We are believing God to do extraordinary things. Extraordinary. Extraordinary. We live in the whole of the United Kingdom. Why don't you book your hotel and join us? Even though it's every evening, but two speakers every evening are worth a hotel room. Some of you live abroad and may require a 5-day lockdown. That's okay. Lockdown, but join us and be blessed. Be blessed. Make sure you serve the Lord with your tithe, your offering, your seed, and everything God has provided for you. Worship God with your blessings at all times. The International Gathering of Champions will bless you. Always remember to bring people by the messages. Let people be blessed by you also, not just buying for yourself, buy for someone. The Sunday night will be a powerful buzz music night also, along with the Word. It's going to be absolutely awesome. Absolutely awesome. Make sure you support the King's University. Ring our office to make inquiries how you can be part of the great vision. Want to see the day when King's University will make a greater impact than we have ever imagined. All right. I believe you're blessed this morning. May the Lord bless you. Bless your going out. Bless your coming in. Everything you lay your hands on to be blessed in this day. And may your head be lifted with the oil of God. In Jesus' name. The Lord bless you. Dios te bendice. Dios te bendiga. Dios te bendice mucho. Wari va cucumbrere. Unculunculo. Agubusesi. God bless.
Get up and glow every weekday at 6 a.m. at The Morning Glow. Dig deeper into God's Word and enrich your faith at the Global Bible Study every Wednesday at 7 p.m. And on Sundays, join us at 9 a.m. for leadership, inspiration, finance, and entrepreneurship at Life Class. The mid-morning service at 12 noon. And in the evening, be blessed at the Night of the Prophetic and the Fearless at 6 p.m. Be a part of a church without walls with KICC. Join us on social media, KICC TV, KICCTV.org.uk, or download the KICC Church app. KICC, raising champions, taking territories. Kingsway International Christian Center is a church without walls. Join the KICC family online every day. Get up and glow every weekday at 6 a.m. at The Morning Glow. Dig deeper into God's Word and enrich your faith at the Global Bible Study every Wednesday at 7 p.m. And on Sundays, join us at 9 a.m. for leadership, inspiration, finance, and entrepreneurship at Life Class. The mid-morning service at 12 noon. And in the evening, be blessed at the Night of the Prophetic and the Fearless at 6 p.m. Be a part of a church without walls with KICC. Join us on social media, KICC TV, KICCTV.org.uk, or download the KICC Church app. KICC, raising champions, taking territories. Kingsway International Christian Center is a church without walls. Join the KICC family online every day. Get up and glow every weekday at 6 a.m. at the Morning Glow. Dig deeper into God's Word and enrich your faith at the Global Bible Study every Wednesday at 7 p.m. And on Sundays, join us at 9 a.m. for leadership, inspiration, finance, and entrepreneurship at Life Class. The mid-morning service at 12 noon. And in the evening, be blessed at the Night of the Prophetic and the Fearless at 6 p.m. Be a part of a church without walls with KICC. Join us on social media, KICC TV, KICCTV.org.uk, or download the KICC Church app. KICC, raising champions, taking territories. Kingsway International Christian Center is a church without walls. Join the KICC family online every day. Get up and glow every weekday at 6 a.m. at the Morning Glow. Dig deeper into God's Word and enrich your faith at the Global Bible Study every Wednesday at 7 p.m. And on Sundays, join us at 9 a.m. for leadership, inspiration, finance, and entrepreneurship at Life Class. The mid-morning service at 12 noon. And in the evening, be blessed at the Night of the Prophetic and the Fearless at 6 p.m. Be a part of a church without walls with KICC. Join us on social media, KICC TV, KICCTV.org.uk, or download the KICC Church app. KICC, raising champions, taking territories. Kingsway International Christian Center is a church without walls. Join the KICC family online every day. Get up and glow every weekday at 6 a.m. at the Morning Glow. Dig deeper into God's Word and enrich your faith at the Global Bible Study every Wednesday at 7 p.m. And on Sundays, join us at 9 a.m. for leadership, inspiration, finance, and entrepreneurship at Life Class. The mid-morning service at 12 noon. And in the evening, be blessed at the Night of the Prophetic and the Fearless at 6 p.m. Be a part of a church without walls with KICC. Join us on social media, KICC TV, KICCTV.org.uk, or download the KICC Church app. KICC, raising champions, taking territories. Kingsway International Christian Center is a church without walls. Join the KICC family online every day. Get up and glow every weekday at 6 a.m. at the Morning Glow. Dig deeper into God's Word and enrich your faith at the Global Bible Study every Wednesday at 7 p.m. And on Sundays, join us at 9 a.m. for leadership, inspiration, finance, and entrepreneurship at Life Class. The mid-morning service at 12 noon. And in the evening, be blessed at the Night of the Prophetic and the Fearless at 6 p.m. Be a part of a church without walls with KICC. Join us on social media, KICC TV, KICCTV.org.uk, or download the KICC Church app. KICC, raising champions, taking territories.